so much for coming. I'm excited to play Scriabin's 8th piano for you, piano sonata for you in a few minutes. This lecture is going to be a short lecture about some of the harmonic and melodic elements of the piece, and I'm also going to connect those elements to the element of color, which was an important part of Scriabin's music. The 8th sonata is a transitional work. It follows the 7th sonata, known as the White Mass, which has a more harmonic approach, and it precedes the 9th sonata, the Black Mass, which has a more contrapuntal approach. The work is based on a 7-note pitch set. These are the 7 notes in scale form. By pitch set, we mean a group of notes that may be combined in any way. So this is different from what we would consider the traditional rules of common practice tonality, where the combinations are strictly controlled. Here, these notes may be combined in any way. Distribution means how Scriabin distributes the notes across the piano during the piece. In other words, how are the notes combined? While there are probably millions or hundreds of millions of possibilities, Scriabin has his preferred distributions, and these are in some way common to all of his late works, but some of them are specific to the 8th sonata, which gives it its particular sound. These notes can be distributed harmonically and also melodically. Harmonic distribution basically means chords, simultaneous or arpeggiated. Sometimes these chords are in root position. In other words, A is the lowest sounding note. Other times they're inverted, in which case one of the other notes is the lowest sounding pitch. The opening sonority is in root position, and it sounds like this. Notice that the first 3 notes of this sonority form a dominant 7th chord, and the upper notes are in a series of thirds. This is a very common distribution in the 8th sonata. Here, we notice that the F sharp is not present, so not all of the notes need to be present at any time. In this case, notice the D sharp is the 2nd note, forming a dissonant interval with the low A. Sometimes the chords are inverted. In this case, C sharp is the lowest note. Here, D sharp once again forms a dissonant interval with the A, this time from below. And here is another example of the same thing. Replace the D sharp as the lowest note. These notes can also appear as part of a melody. The example I just played for you has this melody. In another case, we see these notes. alliteration occurs quite frequently in the Eighth Sonata. This happens when one or the or more of the original notes is altered by half step. The way these occur in the Eighth Sonata is very consistent. Here are the seven notes again. Here we see B can be lowered by half step to B flat, C sharp lowered to C, D sharp to D, F sharp to F, and G can be raised to G sharp. These appear almost always in the Eighth Sonata, either next to or even simultaneously with the unaltered counterparts. And like the original notes, they can be used harmonically and melodically. The opening of the sonata contrasts two sonorities. The first one has two altered pitches, B flat and D, and the second one has them resolve to their unaltered counterpart. Here, notice that the C natural contrasts with the C sharp. This gives the music a sense of minor contrasting with major. Sometimes the F sharp will appear next to the F natural. In some places, the G sharp appears next to the G. Other times, the chromatic alterations appear as part of a melody. This is the opening melody of the Eighth Sonata. In this example, D sharp is followed by D. And here G sharp and G are next to each other. When we take the seven notes and we combine them with the five chromatic alterations, we produce the fully chromatic scale with all 12 chromatic pitches. Here they are, starting and ending on A. If we analyze this scale, we see that it has one flat and four sharps, and we can refer to that as its key signature. This key signature, one flat and four sharps, is the tonic or the home key of the Eighth Sonata. Throughout the work, the music moves through different key signatures. We can always determine what key the piece is in by observing all the sharps and flats operating in a given section of music. For example, here we see a chromatic scale, which contains the key signature of seven flats. This chromatic scale has one sharp and four flats. It's well known that Scriabin associated color with key. For him, each key was represented by a distinct color. This color wheel indicates the color that he associated with each of the keys. For today's performance, the score has been colored in based on the color Scriabin associated with the key and will be projected behind the piano during the performance. For example, if a section is in the key of A, with one flat and four sharps, it's been colored green, while in the section the key of C has been colored red. Why is color an important part of Scriabin's music? First of all, we want to remain faithful to the composer's vision. Scriabin was interested in combining sound and sight and even smell into one Gesamtkunstwerk, or total artwork. For the performer, understanding the color is a very important part of any interpretation of any piece. This performer is always trying to bring color out of the music, and in this case, we can do that literally. And for the audience, color is just another way to engage with the music. Therefore, color brings together composer, performer, and listener. I will now perform the Eighth Sonata in its entirety. If you have any questions afterward, I'll be outside in the lobby. If you'd like to ask any questions, or if you'd like to take a look at the score closer, this is going to be kind of a far away version. But thank you so much for listening, and here is the performance.
Didn't practice.